गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन टीचिंग सेशन ऑफ एकेडमी वर्ल्ड स्कूल विनीता। टुडे वी आर हियर अगेन विथ आवर क्लास 9 केमिस्ट्री फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज मैटर इन आवर सराउंडिंग्स। लास्ट क्लास वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ग्राफ ऑफ द चेंज ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ मैटर। सो टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अगेन विद द ग्राफ द चेंज ऑफ स्टेट ऑफ मैटर। वी विल स्टार्ट हियर विद एन एक्सपेरिमेंट टुडे। द एक्सपेरिमेंट एज it is given in NCERT, you all can refer to that experiment. Here in this experiment you can see I have taken stand, burner, beaker, thermometer, again stand. Here I have taken ice. So this is the setup for the experiment. So what experiment we are going to do today? We are going to see the temperature variation with the change of state of matter. As all of us know that the freezing temperature of water is 0 degrees Celsius. So since I have taken here ice, the temperature now with the thermometer is 0 degree. Right now the temperature is 0 degree. You can see first case 0 degree Celsius. Now as we keep burning this burner, the ice will start melting. One thing you all will observe here, ice at 0 degree temperature, it will melt and it will become water at 0 degree Celsius. That means first case, ice at 0 degree Celsius, again we will see water at 0 degree Celsius. Now when the ice melts, it will become water. Now you see, ice at 0 degree Celsius and water at 0 degree Celsius. After becoming water, the temperature of water will start rising. Up to what extent it will rise? Now see, third case we will see, when the heat increases in the water, as you know, keep heating the water, it will become water vapor. So water will start evaporating or vaporizing. That means water will start converting from liquid to gaseous state. Here third case we will see, water at 100 degree Celsius. Then number 4, all the water will become water vapor in the passage of time. Now what will be the temperature of the steam that is going out? Steam at 100 degree Celsius. Obviously we cannot measure the temperature of the steam, but since the water is getting converted to steam at the temperature of 100 degree, we will be calling it steam at 100 degree Celsius. Now in this setup we have seen 3 states of matter: ice, solid, on heating it becomes water, that is liquid. On heating it becomes gas or water vapor. Which is gas in nature. 3 states of matter we came to see in one experiment. Now one of the most important factor here, that how these things are coming, that means ice at 0 degree Celsius and water at 0 degree Celsius. Okay, what are at 0 degree Celsius?
2 steam
at 0 degree Celsius. Let us see the concept in a broader way by utilizing a graph. In this graph, this is time, this is temperature, zero. So we will start the temperature from 0 degree Celsius since ice falls at 0 degree Celsius. Now you see, this is the point where ice starts melting. This is the point where ice starts melting. Here again, ice completes melting. Again here, water starts boiling. Here water finishes or completes boiling. Now this point, when the solid or the ice starts melting, the temperature at which it starts breaking into liquid, solid starts breaking into liquid, is called as melting point. This will be the melting point, the initial point, the starting point. Now here, where water starts boiling, is called as boiling point. When ice starts melting, what happens to it? We keep on supplying heat energy. Take the example of this case. Suppose the particle of water are tightly packed in case of ice. Now it was heated. What will happen? Ice will become water. Since the intermolecular force of attraction will decrease and space will increase, now it is water. Temperature is same. Ice at 0 degree, water is 0 degree. So where the additional heat has gone? The amount of heat or the extra heat or the heat energy that has gone to break the bond of the ice to make it water. That means the intermolecular force of attraction, it is broken so that solid becomes liquid. So this kind of heat that is used to change one state to another state at constant temperature is called latent heat. Latent heat. So in this case, conversion of solid to liquid, ice is solid, water is liquid. Conversion of solid to liquid at constant temperature, if the state is changing, then it is called latent heat of fusion. This is very important. Again, I am repeating, the amount of heat energy or the amount of energy required to convert any solid into liquid at constant temperature is called latent heat of fusion. More scientifically, it can be said that the amount of heat required to convert 1 kg of solid into liquid at the melting point is called latent heat of fusion. Again, similar case, if we take water and water vapor, water it was 100 degree Celsius and this is 100 degree Celsius. As all of us know, the boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius. You cannot heat water more than 100 degree Celsius. All of the water will become water vapor. So, while heating water, it will start increasing its temperature up to 100 degree Celsius. That means, at 100 degree Celsius, the steam or the water vapor and water exist together. At this point, where the heat, additional heat, after 100 degree Celsius, whatever heat we are supplying to the water, where it is going? So, this is also a type of latent heat. Latent means heat and heat. You see, this intermolecular force of attraction of water, this force of attraction was broken by the heat. Heat energy overcomes the force of attraction between water particles to make it steam or water vapor. At this point, we call it latent heat or vaporization. As we say, solid to liquid, latent heat of fusion. Here, this will be called latent heat of vaporization. This heat and supply will be called latent heat of vaporization. Here it will be called latent heat of fusion. So now we all can understand latent heat of fusion means conversion of 1 kg of solid to liquid at the melting point of the substance. And latent heat of vaporization means conversion of 1 kg of liquid into gas at its boiling point. You can see from the graph, from the melting point, when the ice starts melting to when the ice completes melting, the temperature remains the same. That means the temperature doesn't change. This is the temperature graph. This is the graph of the temperature. Temperature doesn't change. In same case, the boiling point, whenever water starts boiling and water completes boiling, the temperature graph is same. So whatever heat is absorbed by the substance here is utilized to break the intermolecular force of attraction of the substance. In this case for ice and in this case for water. These are the concepts of latent heat. Now let us define the latent heat and its types. You all can pause this and draw these diagrams in your notebooks. Latent heat, it can be defined as amount of heat required to change the state of matter at constant and atmospheric heat. So this is the latent heat. So two types of latent heat are there. One is called latent heat of fusion which can be defined as the amount of heat required to convert 1 kg of solid to liquid at the melting point of the solid and under atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure means there is no additional pressure applied under the same condition of temperature and pressure for everything. Atmospheric pressure means whatever pressure the air or the atmosphere is exerting on the change of the state of matter, that is atmospheric pressure. 1 bar normally it is here. Again, second case, latent heat of evaporation. The amount of heat required to convert 1 kg of liquid to gas at the boiling point of the liquid under atmospheric pressure. So these are two types of latent heat. You can pause this thing and write the definitions. So for water, as we took the example of water, latent heat of fusion it will be at 0 degree Celsius and latent heat of vaporization will be at 100 degree Celsius for water. Here it will be ice. Here is for water. Okay. Related to this topic, there are few questions. Question 1. Which of the following will have more kinetic energy? Phosphate, ice at 0 degree Celsius or water at 0 degree Celsius. Second case, water at 100 degree Celsius or steam at 100 degree Celsius. Now, both the questions you have to answer by relating to the experiment we have done and the concept of latent heat we understood right now. So here the answer will be C. Kinetic energy, we have been discussing about kinetic energy from the first class only. So between ice and water, you can easily distinguish that water will have more kinetic energy. But you see, temperature is same, ice at 0 degree Celsius and water at 0 degree Celsius. So you can write or you can think water at 0 degree Celsius will have more kinetic energy because water at 0 degree Celsius has latent heat of fusion which increases the kinetic energy of water than ice. This will be the answer. You see, whenever heat is supplied, even at 0 degree Celsius, the heat supplied is used not to increase the temperature but to break the bond of ice, to convert into water from solid to liquid. For the conversion only the heat is used. That means ice at 0 degree Celsius will have less kinetic energy than water at 0 degree Celsius. Second case, water at 100 degree Celsius or steam at 100 degree Celsius. Same case, you can easily understand that steam at 100 degree Celsius will have more kinetic energy than water at 100 degree Celsius. So answer here will be since steam at 100 degree Celsius has latent heat of vaporization which increases the kinetic energy of the steam. Then water at 100 degrees Celsius. One reasoning type question comes in the exam that which will cause more severe burn, steam at 100 degrees Celsius or water at 100 degrees Celsius? So answer will be steam, because steam is having more kinetic energy and more energy than water. So if the steam at 100 degrees Celsius falls on our skin or passes through our skin, so it will cause more severe burn than water at 100 degrees Celsius. So it is a one of the most important question that comes in the board exams. Water at 100 degrees Celsius or steam at 100 degrees Celsius, which has more energy? Obviously, steam has more energy. And the first case, ice at 0 degrees Celsius, water at 0 degrees Celsius. Which has more kinetic energy? Water at 0 degrees Celsius has more kinetic energy because of the absorption of latent heat of fusion in case of ice to water. And second case, latent heat of vaporization in case of water to water vapor. Next is the concept of sublimation. We are still studying the effect of temperature on the state of matter. We study the change of state of solid to liquid, liquid to gas. Again, the second part is sublimation. Another type of conversion of matter is there. Sublimation. It is defined as the process of conversion of solid into gas directly without coming to the liquid state. So the process of conversion of solid into gas directly without coming to liquid state. Students, few examples I would like to cite here. Naphthalene balls. As we keep it for the removal of moths, because it has moth repellent properties. If we keep naphthalene balls in our almira or wherever we have kept our clothes, it repels the moth. But slowly we can see that whenever we keep it and after few months we open it, we can see that the naphthalene ball has either vanished or it has grown smaller. Have you ever wondered why it happens? If change of state would have happened, then it must have come to liquid state, right? But we don't see any liquid there. That means it has converted directly from solid to gas. Another example is that camphor. If you keep the camphor openly in open atmosphere or open place, the next day you will find the camphor is not there. That means it has sublimed. That means it has converted from solid to gas automatically, and it is mixed in the air itself. Examples. So there are matters or substances which are sublimable. Examples are naphthalene, naphthalene balls, then camphor, ammonium chloride, etc. Iodine also, we can take example. Solid iodine. So these are four examples where we can see the substance from the solid gets converted directly to gaseous state without coming to liquid state. Obviously, by the increase of temperature only. So sublimation is also a result of increase in temperature. One experiment we will be seeing for sublimation. This is the experimental setup, and the substance we have taken here is ammonium chloride, whose formula is ammonium chloride, and its formula is NH4Cl. We knew that it is a sublimable material. So after this setup, if we start increasing the heat, what will happen? This ammonium chloride, which is solid, that is present in the china dish, will start subliming, that means start converting to gas directly without coming to liquid state. Here we have added one cotton plug so that the sublimed ammonium chloride doesn't escape the funnel. So So after some time, after this setup, after burning, we can see the ammonium chloride getting sublimed and getting deposited here on the wall of the funnel. So here, what changes are happening? This was solid. In between, it is gas. Again, at the deposition side, it is again becoming solid. So the conversion here, ammonium chloride, NH4Cl, solid, it is going to gas. Again, it is becoming solid. So solid to gas to solid. That means this is the process of sublimation. This is the process of sublimation. In the NCERT textbook, this diagram has been given and you all can refer to NCERT book for extra information about this. This experiment we will be doing in the laboratory once we start the classes. So here we come to an end of the effect of temperature on the state change of state of matter. Next comes effect of pressure. On the change of states of matter. So this is very easy. Three states are there for solid. For solid, if we apply pressure, since the composition of solid is very tightly packed, so if we apply pressure from any direction or every direction, solid will not change. It is incompressible. So no effect of pressure. In liquid, liquid in liquid in a closed container, if we keep liquid in a closed container and we start giving pressure from all direction, liquid is having weaker force of attraction, still it is not compressible. We cannot compress liquid, we cannot change the volume of liquid. That means liquid is also incompressible. So for liquid also, no effect of pressure. Next coming to gas. The particles of the gas are highly separated from each other. Now if you give pressure from all direction, it is possible that they may come closer and again pressure, they can come to even solid state of matter. So gases are compressible. That means pressure increase, gas increase in pressure, gas. That means gas and liquid state, and also it can come into solid state on the application of pressure. So from both the data, that means effect of pressure and temperature, we can conclude that solid, liquid and gas these are interconnected. That means whatever state of matter is there, it is a result of temperature and pressure. Less is the temperature, more is the pressure, substance is solid. More is the temperature, less is the pressure, substance is gas. That means if you want to convert gas to solid, what do you do? Conversion of gas to solid. Increase pressure, decrease temperature. Increase pressure and decrease temperature. See, from solid to gas, but just the opposite of it, increase temperature, increase temperature, decrease pressure. And here pressure increased, temperature decreased. So this is the cycle of conversion of solid to liquid to gas. So now the conversion triangle solid, liquid and gas. From solid to liquid, conversion is there. Solid to gas conversion is there. Liquid to gas conversion is also there. So what are the processes called? If the conversion is solid to gas, it is called sublimation. And from gas to solid, it is called deposition. If conversion is from solid to liquid, it is called fusion. Liquid to solid is called solidification. Again, liquid to gas is called vaporization. And gas to liquid is called condensation. Okay, so these are the triangle of the chain of state of matter and the processes involved. Now, this is the end of today's session, and we will be heading with the assignments. 3 questions I am going to give, which will again be sent to you through ERP to try to do the answer of the questions. Question number 1. Why a gas cylinder can't be half filled? Second, the ice cream is older than the water at the same temperature. Number 3, steam at 100 degree causes more severe burn than water at 100 degree सेंसेस. तो थ्री क्वेश्चंस थ्री यू थिंक एंड सॉल्व आंसर एंड सेंड इट थ्रू ईआरपी. विश यू ऑल हैप्पी वेकेशन एंड कीप एंजॉयिंग द स्टडीज अलोंग विथ सॉल्विंग द आंसर्स. थैंक यू.